With an official invitation, we visit Danelle, the largest European supplier of aquatic plants. Maybe the greatest professional in this field is Stefan Hummel. In any case, he's product manager at Danelle, and with him we are taking a tour through the huge greenhouses. First stop is the Echinodorus house. It has 2,500 square meters and is the largest of 8 greenhouses. A popular plant in the aquarium is the robust and unpretentious Echinodorus ocelot. Some 1,000 sort plants grow on greenhouse tables and very many are flourishing. But most of the Echinodorus are grown at a partner company in Sri Lanka. The farm operates a cultivated area of 60,000 square meters. Once per week, an import of Echinodorus arrives. After an acclimation of few weeks, the sorts can be sold to stores. In the northern lines of latitude, days are short in winter. Without enough light, plants cannot grow optimally. Shortly before dusk, metal halide lamps will be switched on automatically in the greenhouses. It takes more than 10 minutes before the lamps operate at full power. They produce a warm orange light and create an atmosphere like at sunset. The shades are now falsified and the green plants look unnatural yellow. But the artificial light enables chloroplasts to carry out photosynthesis. The lamps burn for a few hours and are off during night. The next morning, daylight illuminates the greenhouses and now we want to know why the plants do not grow underwater. The explanation is simple. Aquarium plants can be fed better and more balanced by cultivating above water.
Das ist die neue Pflanze Ranunculus inundatus.
Production and handling is much easier than with submerged cultivation. But the changeover to submerged is a difficult process for the plants. They need strong roots to grow quickly. Aquatic plants cannot thrive in dry air. For this reason, the air humidity is kept on a high level by atomizing of water. Anubias grow very slowly despite optimal conditions. Danelle imports these robust plants and after an acclimation of few weeks, a part of it is used for the production of so-called Mbuna underwater trees. By yarn and underwater glue, the single plants are attached on driftwood. As the name suggests, these trees were designed for Mbuna aquariums. Mbuna are a group of cichlids from Lake Malawi which like to eat aquatic plants, but anubias have hard wearing and tough leaves. It is no preferred nutrition, neither for Mbuna nor for other herbivorous fish. The Mbuna trees are placed for around 6 weeks in a polytunnel with 100% humidity.
Das sind jetzt die schönen Mbuna-Bäume von Danelle, die hier im
Here the plants develop well and the roots may firmly growing on the wood. Other plants that can be cultivated only in a polytunnel are Crinum. Members of this genus grow from a bulb usually just underwater. Inside the tunnel is a humidity of 100%, sufficient conditions to let the onion plants grow. It takes 4 to 5 months to develop such strong roots and these beautiful long leaves. Danelle itself produces many of its young plants in a separate area of the facility. The ability of plants to reproduce from single cells is the basis of the production, a technique called meristem propagation. If you place single or multiple cells in a sterile nutrient medium, and you give them a controlled environment, then these cells will grow. In a defined size, the cuttings are set by hand in rock wool and potted. Then they are brought into the greenhouse, where they will grow up in few months to stately plants.
Hier sind wir jetzt in unserem Haus für Produktionspflanzen.
Here you see plants in many different stages. For mass production, meristem propagation is very common and is usually used. In many further work steps, the pots will become real aquarium plants. For shipment, the quality is inspected directly on the table. The staff detaches damaged leaves and inserts a sticker with name and information in the pots. In the cleaning area, all plants are examined once more for defects, washed and prepared for shipping. Exactly so, the pots will be offered to aquarists in stores. In the dispatch area, the boxes with the prepared plants are sorted. For an order, different plants are compiled in a plastic shell and then packed for shipment into the whole world. During the season, 80 to 100,000 plants per week are sold to the trade, ready for our aquariums.